The Philippines' seven-member Commission on Elections on Bank now complete. Newly appointed commissioners Nelson Celis and Ernesto Maceda Jr. took their oath before COMELEC Chairman George Garcia in a ceremony Monday. Should they gain the nod of the Commission on Appointments, their term will last until February 2029. Maceda, a seasoned election lawyer, vows to help the commission fulfill its role of providing credible elections for Filipinos.
I will criticize, but constructively. I will comment, but fairly. I will probe deeply. I will question intelligently. And I will challenge the status quo, all in the context of delivery of our mission. To ensure an election process that, in constitutional language, is free, credible, honest, orderly, and peaceful, in statutory language, is informed, in COMELEC resolution language, is gender responsive and socially inclusive, and in PPCRV language, that is meaningful.
There'll be changes on the operations within the office of the press secretary. That statement made by its officer in charge, Attorney Teloy Garafil, during Monday's flag-raising ceremony in Malacañang. But she admitted she's still wrapping her head around the operations of her agency. Garafil temporarily took the helm of the office after Press Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles resigned last week. Garafil said President Marcos offered her the OIC position. She was previously the chair of the country's land transport regulatory body.
Actually, ang ano ko naman, hindi na importante kung OIC o full-fledged na secretary. Ang mahalaga sa akin, ang importante sa akin, yung trust and confidence na binigay sa atin ng ating Pangulo. Na binigyan niya tayo ng pagkakataon at trust na makatulong sa OPS.
Philippine Senator Nancy Binay wants the implementation of the screening system One Health Pass scrapped. Binay asserts the use of the system is becoming more inconvenient for travelers. She also fears One Health Pass might just turn away potential tourists. Binay says the tourism department and other agencies should look into simplifying the processes that visitors have to undergo.
Transportation Chief Jaime Bautista says government aims to upgrade and expand various airports through public-private partnership deals. Jackie Pascual now joins us to tell us more. Jackie?
Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista is pushing for public-private partnership deals for many transport projects in the country. At the Economic Journalists Association of the Philippines Forum in Pasay, Bautista revealed that 10 regional airports will be upgraded, expanded, and operated under a PPP scheme. These airports include the Bohol-Panglao International Airport, Lagindingan International Airport, Bicol International Airport, Iloilo International Airport, Puerto Princesa International Airport, Davao International Airport, Bacolod-Silay International Airport, Calibo International Airport, and the Siargao and Butuanga Airports. PPP Executive Director Maria Cintia Hernandez said they are working with the DOTR on how to go about these airport PPP deals. They will study if airports will be bundled or not. Hernandez says that it depends on the financial feasibility and the economics of it. Bautista, meanwhile, also said they will be improving Ninoy Aquino International Airport and Clark International Airport, especially since the two new big airports in Bulacan and Sangli in Cavite will not be operational anytime soon. And aside from airports, Bautista also sees possible PPP for seaports. He calls it a viable option. And once seaports are managed privately, he said the Philippine Ports Authority will just now be a regulatory body. And that's the latest. Back to you.
Thanks, Jackie.